Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope guys you all are doing good in iOS. It's my request you guys, please support me in this video and also share your thoughts with me in a comment. Recently guys, what happened, like recently Apple has released that we can select multiple row using two fingers. In a device, like you can see, I'm just drag the rows and I'm going to deselect and select all the rows. It's a really cool thing. And the thing is that if we have to do this thing in iOS 12, we have to implement pen gesture, and this is available for iOS 13 only. So make sure if you are implement this thing in your project, then this is gonna work in only for an iOS 13 devices. So I'm just going to explain the thing that I have implemented. I have just created one model. It contains two values, name and isSelected. isSelected is a boolean value that indicate that the row is selected or not, and the name is taking or the technology's names, and my array name is ArrayTech, and I already implement the action of done button and the data source method that we commonly use for a table views. Okay, so first thing that we have to do the multiple row selection, we have to enable multiple gesture for our table view. So just write the table view dot allow multiple selection during editing is equals to true. So now we can allow that table is going to be select multiple row, like multiple selection. Here I'm going to take one extension of view controller, and I'm going to implement all the delegate method that we want for multiple selection of row. So first one is, should we select the multiple selection interaction? Fine. So if it falls, it return boolean value, right? If it falls, then we cannot select multiple row. So if it true, then you can implement this thing. So should begin multiple selection, true. Then the second method, when we begin, so did begin multiple selection. If you see this in video, like if I just drag, okay, so this method is called. So what we have to do, we have to do that our table is going to be in a editing mode. So table view dot set editing mode to true, and animation of course true. And the last one, if I deselect all the row, then did and method is called, did and multiple selection. If you have selected all the rows and if you end it, then this method is called. So I'm just going to print that function name here, so you can get idea about this. So when it called, so I'm just going to print the function. Let's run this and let's see that our multiple row selection is working or not. Getting error. Yeah, let's see. Two finger in a cell, just drag. You can see this is going to be work very well. Okay, so the next step is, we want our selected row in a done button. Okay, so what we have to do, in a done button, the table editing mode is not, we don't want editing mode in a done click, and also we want all the selected rows. So if you know guys, if in a did select method, the cell is called, if you are selecting iOS, then did select method is called. If you unselect iOS, then did deselect method is called. Did select method is called when you select iOS, and did deselect method is called when you selected iOS value and deselect that. So here I'm just going to print that deselect method is called, and also print that did select method is called. So why I am printing here, I just want to show one thing. that's if you are visible, I hope you visible the console. If you are select just three rows, then you can see did select method is called multiple times, guys. You can see I have just selected three rows only, and just I ended, that's why this function is called, because we just printed out this. The thing is, the did select method is called multiple times. So how to handle this thing? If you are unselect all thing, all the rows, then this method is called only three times. So like did deselect method, it's working fine. It's called according to the deselect row, but when you selected, then it called multiple times. Okay, so first of all, what we have to do, if I select iOS, okay, if you can see, if I'm just going to select iOS, then did select method is called. So here I'm just going to do that my selected id is true, right? So index path dot row like is selected is true because it's selected. And if I click on iOS again, then did deselect method is called. So here the now the is selected state is false. So we can do this thing in another way, like we just have to write toggle. So I'm just going to explain you what toggle is do. So what toggle is do, guys, if my is selected value is false, then it set true, and if its selected value is true, then it set false, like opposite value of the is selected boolean value, right? And also it's like if my is selected boolean is true, then we no need to call this method multiple times. So how we can avoid this? You can do two way. If table view, if array tag index path dot row dot is selected, if it's selected true, then we just return it. Okay, if already my row is selected, then I really don't want to call this many times. So this thing is working here. Okay, and the same thing is, if my row is deselect already, then this method is not going to call multiple times. So if it's selected, it directly return it, and if it not selected, it directly return it. Okay, so let's see that now our did select method is called multiple times or not. So with the two finger, I'm just going to select five row, and if you can see, guys, it's just going to call five times. So it's good. And also with the deselect method is also called five times, because I just unselect all the rows. So it's working good now. Okay, and we also manage our is selected state also. So we can also get selected state is true, that value it is are selected in a row. So second thing, if you know this thing, that if it right now is in editing mode, okay, so if you use table view is editing mode, so it's written true right now. So if you want to do anything in a did select method is tab, so you can do like this. If it's editing mode, then it's true, so you can do all things. Like if I'm just showing you table view dot is editing else, so this else statement is called when editing mode is off, and this method is called when editing mode is on. It's just for the knowledge. Okay, guys, now we want all the selected row in a done button. But one thing I am going to do here, our table view is in right now is editing mode, but when we click on the done button, we don't want this table view on a editing mode. Okay, so we have to just set the editing to false, because we don't want. And also I am just going to print all the selected row, right? So array tag dot filter $0 dot is selected is equals to true. See, all the row that is selected, it going to return here because we manage our boolean value very great. So like this is going to work fine. I'm just going to select this and this six values and let's press done. You can see iOS, like we can see 6 iOS, Android, ReactJS and all. So we manage our state, that's why I am getting perfect value here. So guys, this is the thing that we can use multiple rows in only on iOS 13 using two fingers. I hope guys this video is going to be helpful for you. If you have any suggestion, then please comment me. I'm going to catch you in the next video. Thank you so much guys for the support and your love. Bye bye guys.